Today, I'm gonna show you how to obtain a cinematic look by color grading your images in Lightroom, and we are starting right now. I opened up this very cool image with an athlete preparing to make a deadlift exercise. When making a color grading, try to adjust the photo to have a low contrast because this will give you a better control on the details. And question of the day, guys, when are you adjusting your contrast? Before starting to take photos or in post-production? Leave your comments below. So I will start here by adjusting the temperature of this image. I'm trying to find a neutral look for the white balance, and I think that a negative 4 or 5 will be a good choice for the moment. Next, I will try to bring back some details here in the windows area. So I'm pushing the highlight slider to the left side. I will move down to the split toning area now. This is the place where I can add specific colors for the shadows and highlights. But I will need to choose colors which are complementing each other. I have a lot of red in my image, in the bricks and her skin. The complementary colors could be red with green, blue with orange and so on. You can check out this website called Adobe Color CC. I drop your link in the description where you can choose here complementary colors and then have some fun by choosing the perfect tones for your image. In my case, because I have a predominant red color in the photo, I will use red for the shadows and the light green for the highlights. So let's get back into Lightroom now and choose that greenish color. It's not too dark. This is for the highlights. And for the shadows, I will use a light red also. If the saturation doesn't feel so right, you can adjust the sliders like I do now by setting a new value, because remember, you don't need to overdo the color grading. The final look should be very soft, very delicate. I can also use this balance slider if I want to push this toning more to the green part, so I will set it to 20. Let's choose some values in the camera calibration tab. I want to cool down the dark floor and the shadows, so I'm gonna grab the blue primary hue slider, drag it to the left to, let's say, minus 40 or so, and push the saturation to the maximum. Keep in mind that these settings cannot be the same for your image, so you'll have to deal with these values on your own and see what works for you. Okay, I think it's time to crop my image. If I want that film look, I need to go at least with a 16:9 ratio, so I'm going to choose the crop tool, and from the aspect ratio, I'm going to choose 16:9. I'm going to try to respect the rule of thirds and keep her face on this line, making sure also to have a point of interest somewhere near this line, in my case, the lifting bar. I will add some contrast to the image, something like that. And now I will come down to the tone curve, and on the RGB channel, I create a point here in the shadows area. Then I start pushing this point upwards to create this very popular matte effect by crushing the blacks. I think I can increase the exposure just a bit to a 0.5, for example. Okay, so let's have a look at the before and after. You can hit the backslash on the keyboard to switch between the before and after, and you can also press on this icon right here to have the before and after side by side. This way you can see the huge difference between the original and the edited version. It looks awesome! So, if you have friends who don't know how to color grade images using Lightroom, share this tutorial with them and subscribe for more well-explained tutorials. I'm Chris, thanks so much for watching and catch you in the next one.